Happy Independence Day.
Yes. Thank you. Same to you.
And today we have Pastor Lloyd Moll delivering the sermon. We have assisting him, Reverend Jack Lehman.
Okay.
Our minister of music is Bud Bowen, and our song director today is Glenn Lehman. And I thank you all, and have a wonderful day.
Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Nancy. Let's open this morning's service with hymn number 64 in your songbook. America the Beautiful. Before we bow our heads or lift our hearts and our eyes to the heavens, I want you to all turn around and look around this room. Take a look. Look. This is America. Happy 4th of July, America. Huh. And now, let us bow our heads or take your heart and your eyes to the heavens. And God, Father, Mother God, it is one beautiful day. And we give thanks for this beauty. For as we get involved in our everyday lives, we sometimes forget to take a moment and look around at what we have. And irregardless of what some people may think about our government, local, federal, whatever, no matter what they think about our immigrants coming into this country, for we were all immigrants in the beginning, except for our Native Americans, and God bless them. We have the most wonderful country in the world, and don't you ever, ever forget it. And God, as we go through this day, may your light and your love be with us, and may we all work and play in your love. Amen.
Amen.
And now let us sing the Lord's Prayer. While you are still standing, recite with me the creed of this church. This church was founded in order to teach, promote, and demonstrate metaphysical and spiritual laws. We respect the truth of our religion in order to expand awareness throughout the world, revering all life for the benefit of all mankind. And now you may be seated. And now we're going to do song number 65, which is after 66 in your songbooks. My country, 'tis of thee. Land of thy pilgrims. Readings for the day. The first one is Deuteronomy 33:27. Rest knowing that all is so safe in my hands. Rest in trust. Ceaseless activity is distrust. Without the knowledge that I am working for you, you do not rest. Inaction then would be the outcome of despair. Welcome the knowledge, delight in it. Such a truth is as a rope flung to a drowning man. Every repetition of it is one pull nearer shore and safety. Let that illustration teach you a great truth. Lay hold of the truth, pray it, affirm it, hold it on to the rope. How foolish are your attempts to save yourself? One hand on the rope and one making efforts to swim ashore. You may relinquish your hold of the rope and hinder the rescuer, who has to act with the greater caution lest he lose you. The storms and tempests are not all of life. The psalmist who said, "All thy waves and thy billows are gone over me," wrote also, "He brought me up also out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock, and established my goings." Meditate upon that wonder, truth, the three steps, safety, security, and guidance. He brought me up also out of a horrible pit. He set my feet upon a rock. He established my goings, which is guidance. Number three is the final stage, when the saved soul trusts me so entirely it seeks no more its own way, but leaves all future plans to me, its rescuer. And the second reading for today is taken from Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. Jesus, say my name often. It was in my name Peter bade the lame man walk. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, arise and walk. Now Jesus, the very sounding of my name in love and tenderness, drives away all evil. It is the word before which all the host of evil flee. Jesus, my name is the call for a lifeline to rescue you from temptation. Jesus, the name banishes loneliness and dispels gloom. Jesus summons help to conquer your faults. I will set you on high because you have known my name. Yes, my name Jesus. Use it more. Use it tenderly. Use it prayerfully. And use it powerfully. And so is the reading for today. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I turn the service over to Reverend Lloyd Moll with his continuing message to this congregation. Reverend Lloyd.
Thank you. You know, he was gracious enough to allow me this service today. One thing I want to make very clear. The words that are spoken today, you have to forgive me. The words spoken today are not meant to penetrate or to hurt. They're only meant to listen to and to take into your own thinking, your own way of knowing your God, your Jesus Christ. That is all it is about. Abraham, which is my teacher, most of his things that come are directly from him through God. I have not much of reading a lot of books. I found that when I read the books, and it verifies that which was said. This is the first thing that we'll start this morning is free will versus thy will. I'm going to ask you, we just sung the Lord's Prayer. This is the part I want you to realize and know. It has no character meaning to destroy or to allow you to feel bad about yourself. What it's trying to do is to get you to understand what these words are, free will and thy will to be done. It says, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, and thy will be done. The most important part of this, of the Lord's Prayer, I want you to think. I mean, really think about it before you try to answer it. And that's the part where it says, as we forgive our trespasses, lead us not into temptation and deliver us. I am way off base this morning. And forgive all these trespasses. But where it says, as we can give and we forget to give and forgive our trespassers that are against us. Do you really understand what that is saying? Do you truly, really know what that is saying? I doubt it very much because I know when I used to say it, it was just a thing to say. But when you really get down to it and you bring out the word, as he forgives us, we are to forgive those who trespass against us. And we say it so easily. And yet we turn around and we hurt each other. We hurt each other to the point sometimes it really gets so bad we don't know what to do with each other. Thy will is not free. It doesn't come just for that reason. Free will became a word for which it gave us an excuse. God says, well, if you want free will, go ahead and do it free will. We don't care. But remember one thing. When you take free will, you no longer have my way of thinking. And it is that which you begin to know and bring upon yourselves. What do you think that makes all this trouble with us? Why do we have all the problems, the wars, shooting each other? Because we don't have thy will to be done. You remember last week, I asked and asked over and over to please remember that you're the Spirit of God. You're the completeness of everything He is. But yet we don't understand how or what to do about it. God even said at the time when we took on flesh, you've got to remember, your spirit is no longer free. It no longer has the ability to do everything that I can do because you want to encase it. You want to be seen. But don't you understand that that is what is I am? It is all that I am that you are, the God essence within you. And until you wake that spirit up, until you allow it to become part of you, if you run up to someone and all of a sudden they do something, take a moment, a split second, and just remember what it says in the Lord's Prayer. Trespassing against me, I will forgive you. I don't have to love you and your flesh, but I will love your spirit. I will love that God essence that's in within you. I don't have to worry anymore what you feel about me. Your thoughts are your thoughts, and you have a right to them, but not to allow them to diminish anyone else. So please, if we want our world and our universe back that God created so beautifully, start taking the time to understand that He really, really loves us. I mean, His love is so free. It's just shared with us. Because now the other word is that unconditional. I used that word a few times. Well, it don't work. Man, if unconditional love would work, we wouldn't have nothing. We'd have all the world by the, we'd have it by the tail. You can use unconditional for many other sources of things in life. But God doesn't say, I give unconditional love to you. I give unconditional love to you. It don't explain anything near what He has within Himself to share with you, what you have inside of you. It's completeness of love. Just the word. Love. L-O-V-E. Get that in yourself. Get that to understand. It's not unconditional. I can have an unconditional fall. I don't know if that would work, but I could try it. But just have a love. Receive it and share it. This is the whole thing in our universe. This is the whole thing, everything that is to be. Free will. Put it in the garbage. Boy, when you drive down the highway, there's so much free will, it's crazy. I mean, you don't know whether the one person's going to pull out or if you're supposed to wait. You have no idea. Nobody seems to have a conscience anymore. I'm first. Get out of my way. Well, it don't work like that. You know, I get caught up in that. I know sometimes at this one spot, I see the car coming and I know that it's not going to let me make the right turn. And I purposely pull out. And the one day I did this, and I shouldn't even tell you, but I did. I pulled around the turn to go across the 8th Street Bridge, and these young couple had kids in the car. He stepped on the gas, pulled up. I had to avoid him. He lost control and went up on the pavement. Down there went through the barrier of the bridge. I thought to myself, my God, what would I have done if that would have happened? Huh? What would I have done? I would have never been able to forgive myself. It's so dumb. So I've taken free will, and I'm starting to say, whoa, wait a minute. I love stuff free, especially food. That free will, boy, that burger gets me into more trouble. So I just decided I don't need it anymore. I really don't need it anymore. I still slip. I'm no different than anybody else. And that's the same thing with Christ. He pulled some dandies in his day. But who cares? Why do we have to, in our society today, why do we have to prove that these things exist? Why can't we believe and understand that God is what it is of the essence of everything that is? Every moment of life, God is the presence of what is right at this moment. He doesn't say, wait a minute, I have to check first. He says, you're my child. Ask and believe, and it will be so. I just talked to a young lady this morning, and I said, you know what? Sometimes I have trouble with that too. Because I know what's happening, and I know when it's, I don't know when it's coming, because that's one thing they don't let me know. Even my teacher won't let me know. Because if he does, then I already know. I won't anticipate. And it's the same thing if God says, well, if I give you everything, what do you have to work for? I mean, everything just happens then. You know, we did all of these things. Everything that happens now in our world today, we can thank each other because we did it. We made it. Every word that is spoken in that fancy language that we get to use sometimes, we created it. And we speak it. Boy, does some of them rattle it off. Woo! But it's the very moment that we slip. You know, God didn't make bad people. It's just the flesh that got in the way. Our spirit is still as pure as... Oh, I can't even find a word to say how pure it is. And how caring and how loving it is. So it is all these things that you have to start. My word isn't the law. I said, you have to get free will and put it aside so you start using your will. I don't know how you think or how you feel. The The same with that word, now I can't even say it. What was I saying about love? Unconditional.
Unconditional.
I don't know. All I know is it don't work for me. But I don't know. Maybe it works for you. But if it does, try to put a little bit of thy will in there. I tell you, it'll work a lot better. So anyway, I do really thank Jack for allowing me this, because Abraham was really, he's quite a man. And here's some, no. I'm afraid if he does say, he might have words that I don't know that should be said right at the moment. I understand he did speak last Sunday. I don't even know what the words were, but whatever it was. But he is a very powerful young man. And you know what I like about him so much? Because I can trust him. I used to get so upset because he wouldn't give me these little ins and outs.